This one, actually, I was telling Janet about this. Where is she? There she is. She always speaks out of my vision. She does the pit bull. And she usually asks me once or twice a year to put a poem in there, and I'm usually never ready. So this year I thought, I'll be ready. So I wrote this poem, and it's thanks to Ken going to his dentist's where he can't get parked anymore down at Nelson's Crescent, so I sit in the car and wait for him with nothing to do, a pen and paper. So I thought, I'll do this one, and hopefully Janet will like it for the piffle. It's called Somewhere Inside Eternity.
What's the piffle?
It's a magazine that Janet has Poet's Corner in. Every month it comes out. And this month hers is in there, and I read it, Janet. It's really good. It's really good.
I think I wrote that when I was half asleep.
It was good.
I was worried about it.
Anyway. So anyhow, somewhere inside eternity. Close your eyes and imagine this in New Westminster. The waxing indigo veil of night shawls over Columbia Street, and somewhere inside eternity, the past and present meet. A battalion of hazy engineers digs in the heart of the city to resurrect lost relics buried in iniquity. These ghostly archaeologists populate the dark of the night, blending with the fog and mist inside the fading light. Now, in the year 2018, the streets are packed with bikes and cars, pedestrians, scooters, and traffic lights, and neon signs obliterating the stars. The days of simplicity are now long gone, and yesterday's safety nets torn and frayed. We've lost the sweetness of the song and the message it conveyed. Somewhere inside eternity, dissolving in the fading light, yesterday and today pass by like strangers in the night. The waning indigo veil of night lifts over Columbia Street. Tomorrow will soon become yesterday, and never the twain shall meet. Thanks a lot. Oh, one last quick one. This is a very, very short one.